This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Thursday, the 5th of July. I'm Vanessa Garcia. GSLP alliance clinches by-election with almost 10% lead. Albert Isola sworn in as government minister. Locally employed man caught in heroin arrest. Summer night's programme announced. And finally, big up Diaz charity, concert set for tomorrow evening. Albert Isola, the GSLP candidate in yesterday's by-election, came first by a margin of almost 10% in the public vote. Mr. Isola, who secured 4,899 votes, beat the GSD candidate, Marlene Nahon, who received 3,927. The PDP's Nick Gruss received 688 votes, and independent candidate Brian Zamit secured a total of 315 votes. The overall turnout for the by-election was 10,034, which represents 46.34% of the electorate, a figure slightly lower than that of 48.83% for the last by-election in 1999, and much lower, as expected, than the last general election, which saw 82.52% of the electorate turn out to vote. YGTV caught up with Mr. Isola following the vote count for an insight into how he was feeling.
Albert, congratulations. How are you feeling?
It's great. It's been a long, hard slog. By-elections are just one candidate as opposed to general with 10. So you take it all on yourself. I've had a huge amount of support from everybody within the party, so I'm blessed in that sense, but it's still been quite tough. But I'm obviously elated, not just for me, but for the party and the alliance. It's a vote of confidence in what we're doing, and I'm very proud to be part of it.
And what do you put your win down to?
That's a really difficult question. I haven't really thought much about that yet. But I think it's people are happy with what we're doing. People don't want to change and move away from where we're going. And that's hugely encouraging. As I said, it's not about me, it's about the party and the alliance and working together and trying to deliver the change that we started to bring about in 2011. So it's a vote of confidence, I think, primarily.
The full interview can be found on the YGTV website. This morning at 10 a.m, newly elected Member of Parliament and former GSLP candidate in yesterday's by-election, Albert Isola, was sworn into his new position as MP and Minister for the GSLP Alliance Government. His Excellency insisted that the only thing that struck him about this by-election was the fact that there were four candidates, which mean there was a debate and a choice for people. Speaking to YGTV during the count last night, Chief Minister Fabian Bicardo explained that Mr. Isola's ministerial portfolio would be announced on Monday. A cabinet shuffle is expected. Locally employed man Paul Martin, aged 27, was recently arrested and charged by customs officers at the land frontier for the possession of 0.4 grams of heroin and 0.2 grams of cocaine. Mr. Martin was also charged with the importation of the Class A drugs and appeared before the magistrate on Wednesday, the 3rd of July. He entered a guilty plea and has been remanded in custody until July the 24th, when he will be sentenced. With summer nights set to begin next Thursday, the Ministry of Culture has today announced the lineup for the month-long event. The Ministry has worked particularly hard with organisers' fresh events in order to provide a very entertaining programme to be carried out every Thursday and Saturday throughout July and August. The lineup includes performances by Headwires, SPF and Guy Valladino, Jamie Zamit, and The Grease and The Noise, Jetstream and Orange Peel, among others. A bouncy castle and face painting will also be available for children. And finally, ahead of tomorrow's Big Up Diaz charity concert to be held at St. Michael's Cave at 8 p.m, YGTV spoke to one of the event organisers, Annalise Venitas, for more information on what we can expect from the event itself and the story behind the concert.
Annalise, thank you very much for speaking to us. First of all, could you tell us a little bit about the concept behind the concert?
Well, last year on the 12th of March, Philip Diaz sadly passed away from bone cancer, osteosarcoma. He'd been fighting this for just over 2 years, and he was very much into raising money for his chosen charity, which was A Pathway Through Pain. And after he passed away, his friends and family, we decided to carry on raising money, because he himself raised over £12,000. And in the school, we actually did raise £10,000 with a swim and a football tournament, which is obviously carried on this year. But the family wanted to do something, so his aunt, Nancy Cassano, decided that she wanted to do this musical extravaganza for Philip, because Philip loved music, and she felt that it was a great way of representing him, and obviously paying tribute to him as a person. Because, you know, Philip was a very inspiring young individual, you know, not just through his fundraising, but in his determination to achieve his goals. And so she brought on board all these people, his friends, etc., myself as the compere. And over the year, her partner, Jack Evans, has been arranging all the musical scores, or the majority of the musical scores for the event. So now we've come to a year later, and on Saturday we're holding this. And now what this will involve basically is various different musical acts. We have the Royal Regiment Band, supported by the Highland Band as well. We also have This Side Up and Friends. In This Side Up especially, there are a number of Philip's very, very close friends. And added to that are also particularly close friends as well, who also are very into music and play instruments or sing.
How can people get involved in tomorrow's concert and find themselves some tickets?
Well, tickets can be bought from Music Corner in Main Street. They cost £15 each, and this actually includes transport from the bottom of the cable car, which starts as from 6 p.m. The concert starts at 8 p.m. It's approximately a just over 2 hour concert, and buses will bring you down at the end. But I think you need to hurry, because tickets are nearly sold out.
That's the YGTV News. We're back on Monday. Have a great weekend.